Ladies and gentlemen, it's the culture man, Kenny Burns, and welcome to TKBS, where we inform, impact, and inspire. And we also stay hydrated, because ain't no way I can give you all this energy and not be hydrated while doing it. Go grab your smart water in that sleek bottle right now and put it next to your kale popcorn and get ready for the best show on earth, the Kenny Burns Show. Life's full of choices. Smart water is a simple. Visit drinksmartwater.com and learn more.
The dream is real.
You know what it is. It's the authentic voice of culture. We are TKBS, and I am your lifestyle specialist, Kenny Burns, baby.
And I am Kendra Taylor.
And I am Dr. Sugar. Hey, y'all.
Hey, y'all. Kendra still got the sex worker voice. Yep, she got that new microphone, child. She don't know how to act. And we ain't gonna let them people bother us, Sugar, because we fight. What's that one little move to do? Okay, and we do. All right, I am excited, ladies and gentlemen, because the first week of TKBS fully available in a video format on YouTube is behind us. Y'all showed up and showed out. We appreciate y'all, and we have been working on things to perfect the visual. As you can see, we have the amazing cityscape of Atlanta behind us. That is where the Kenny Burns Show is rooted. We also had some brightness issues. Everybody was like, Kenny, it's a little something going on. Yes, it was the brightness effect on the TV wasn't all the way. You know what I'm talking about? We had some mic issues. So we're fixing the mic issues. Tiffany over there laughing about to fall out of her chair because we just had a whole fight in this motherfucker because the mics weren't right, child. But the dream is real and we are here, and I missed y'all. How were your weekend?
I had a great weekend. Unfortunately, I lost one of my very good friends earlier in the week. That last week, her funeral was Saturday. Okay, I don't know what day it is. Okay, but I chose not to attend her funeral, but I donated to her family because I just don't know what kind of mental space I would be in if I would have gone, and I have to protect my peace at all costs. I am definitely praying for her three sons, her sister, and her mother. Rest in peace, Yolanda. Love you, girl.
Yolanda, rest in peace, my sweet. I'm like that too, though, Sugar. I don't really get into the funeral thing. I've been to two funerals my entire life. My grandfather's over 30 years ago, maybe 40 something years, yeah, ago. My grandmother, 6 years ago. I just like to remember them, how they were, you know. I don't also want to get into like the energies, because you know, when stuff like that happen, I need to be still. I need to be quiet. I need to process, and I need to get myself back going in that mental space of being able to deal with it and still thrive. But I love you, and mwah, virtual hugs. Take all that energy.
Thank you.
And Kendra, you was outside again this weekend. You out here in these streets. We know how you get down.
Yeah, I was just out a little bit. Went to a festival and went out to dinner, that kind of thing. I just hung around the house. Nothing special. Just
nothing special.
Chilling.
You cooked this weekend?
I did not cook this weekend. On the weekends, it's my cheat days now. So, and I haven't really got on my regimen. So I've been getting fussed at by my trainer every time I train. So I'm trying to do better. But weekends are my cheat days. So I went out this weekend for dinner.
Well, stay on her ass, because she, you know, she needs some discipline.
I don't know how to act.
Your mic is clean, too. Thank you for having me. Last weekend, you had some, I don't know what you and Fred was in there doing, but you had some stuff around.
What is happening?
I don't know what's going on. But ladies and gentlemen, you want to know how my week was?
Oh, Kenny Burns, how was your weekend?
You know what, baby? I am so glad you asked. I was in Washington, D.C. for the Congressional Black Caucus weekend. And I want to send a shout out to the legend, Mark Barnes. He and I celebrated the 20th year anniversary of the Hip Hop Caucus at the world famous Park at 14th. Have y'all been there with me yet?
I haven't been there with you. I've been there, but I not been with you.
It don't count. It don't count unless you
are
with me.
You left me at home.
Okay, Howard Homecoming. The 100th anniversary of the game is loading, and I will be there. What is that, the 18th through the 20th, Tiffany? So y'all coming. All right, okay. The tickets are situating, so y'all can be my background dancers. But
okay.
I was up there, and ladies and gentlemen, I put it on. I had on a leopard shirt. Big shout out to DJ Quicksilver, my dog. He was literally, yeah. Why you do that? Yeah, look at this. On that Kendra. By the way, big shout out to Kendra. She's so fine still, child. She's been in the club long as me, and she still got it. Yeah. And I really don't do clubs anymore, you know what I mean? But this is like a spiritual revival for me. You know what I'm talking about? Being in the clubs with the energy and the people and just, you know what I'm saying? Because you one step away from somebody. Like, my booth was on top of another booth. You know what I'm talking about? Then the girl below, she all in her feelings and grabbed my nipple on accident. You know, all the things that just happen, you know what I'm saying? When you just outside in the wild, which is why I had on that leopard on, rawr, you know?
Unhinged. Uncaged.
Yeah, I know. I just share too much with y'all. But I love the interaction. I love the feeling. I love when the people, you know what I'm saying, are in your presence and they want to hear certain music, even though I hate requests. All hosts and DJs hate when y'all ask for requests because we feel like we already take you on a musical love fantasy. Then you want requests, some, you know what I'm saying, some Sexy Red. So I got on that mic and said there will be no Sexy Red plan. Matter of fact, true story, big shout out to DJ Windy City because the next day, we did the same thing all over again. Big shout out to old boy Ali, one of my best friends in the entire world. And literally, y'all, when I tell you, I was coming back from the bathroom. And I don't know why I'm doing the shoulders like y'all be doing. Let's see, look at Sugar poking it out. Got her tongue all in her nose. Like, it's literally a problem when I hear, come on. It's like a chemical reaction goes into my brain. You know what I'm talking about? And all of a sudden, I heard DJ Windy City. Big shout out to DJ Windy City, too. But I heard them playing this record. I said, I was like, I know that ain't the girl that just came from the gynecologist. And so everybody looking around like, who is saying it? Because I'm coming from the bathroom, right? I'm coming from the bathroom. I'm like, I know that ain't Stanky. Is that Stanky Red? And they like, this man is crazy. So I get up to the booth. I cut the music off. I said, y'all ain't ready to listen to nobody that stank, are y'all? That's going to the gynecologist talking about his stank. Do y'all want to hear this? As a matter of fact, if you want to hear stanky coochie music, make some noise.
Everybody on mute.
You could hear a pin drop in that joint. They were like, is this man on drugs? I was on tequila. But anyway, I had a great time. And I just love that interaction. And I love to test my things too. Cause that Sexy Red thing, it went over well at Tuskegee University. So I was like, damn, if the kids who listen to this faithfully are hearing what I'm saying, there might be some truth to it. But had a great time. And I love my hometown. I love my hometown. I also had an opportunity to go by Hanover Street. I want y'all to pay attention to my cryptic posts, okay? My next project is loading, so I'll be saying things about this project as I go, and I just want you to follow the pieces to the puzzle. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is episode 101. That's right, 101 episodes. And this weekend inspired the name of this episode, and it's called Everyday People. Oh yeah, I love my everyday people. I love walking, meeting new people, you know what I'm saying? Just randomly down the street, in the airport. I love when people tell me how I'm impacting their life. These are everyday people that DM me. I don't know these 311,000 people that follow me on Instagram. I don't know these millions of people that hear me across all platforms, but they have things to say and things they want to tell me about how this platform makes them feel. And I love you for that. And I love my everyday people. And I want to start our discussion off, and I'm going to come to you first, Sugar. You know, people are losing faith in everyday people. They're losing faith in everyday jobs. And we got to get back on the right track. We can't hold these visuals we see on Instagram, these things we see in other people do, we can't hold that against everyday people. How do you feel, Dr. Sugar? Talk to me.
I've said this time and time and time again. Your standard for success cannot be based on someone else's ladder.
Amen. Round of
applause. You cannot do that to yourself. So whenever you interact with somebody who has a 9-to-5, i.e. Sheryl Rae Reid, okay, I'm still the same as the person that you see behind this mic. I'm still the same as a person with the stature as like Kenny Burns, you know? He has all the things and all of the experience. We also, all the people around, we also have things and experiences too. So one of the things that bothers me, honestly, Kenny, is when folks try to treat folks wrong or off because of what they do or what they don't have or what they can offer or what they can't offer or what you think they got and what you don't think they got. Because I am so sick of people looking at the cafeteria worker being rude. I'm sick of people looking at the janitor being rude. Yeah. I'm sick of people looking at teachers being rude. Baby, y'all would not last a moment.
Yeah. And I feel you, but that's why, like, even when I was thinking about this episode, everyday people are what make the world go round. And people are amazed. If I have a Uber driver and I'm going to stop and get some food, I ask them if they want something to eat. It's just, to me, the right thing to do. And Kendra, I just feel like we're not even showing common courtesy no more with the people that literally are helping us get to where we're going, making our food, straightening up our hotel rooms. I mean, how do you feel about that, Kendra? Because it's a lost art to me.
One of my pet peeves is when I enter into a conversation or into a room of professionals and their first question to me is, what do you do?
Mm-hmm.
First of all, I feel like that's kind of like an insult, or they're trying to pry to see if you're worthy of a conversation. I once had a mentor when I was a wedding planner. I was going into high-end weddings, so I was going to deal with a different stature of people. Well, she welcomed to go ahead and mentor me, but she went out of her way to come and pick me up from my home. And to me, it was like she wanted to see where I stayed, to see if I was worthy of dealing with those type of people. And then once she had that comfortability with me and seen what I had and what I didn't have and who I was and what I was capable of, then it was like, now you have permission to do what I do. And I feel like that's kind of like it's a dig. And it's not right.
Yeah, it's whack. It's not showing that you truly believe in someone's talent. They have to have all these extras to be a part of your mix. You know, I don't think people think about the impact of those actions. And I want to talk about the impact of those actions, because I've met many of people that have been discouraged from literally pursuing their dreams because of what someone had to say. I'm watching these kids in basketball right now. I'm talking about D1 high major basketball players that are not interested anymore. And this is one case. I forgot the guy's name. Kenny had been following him forever. He went to Alabama most recently, I think. And he literally said he's giving up basketball because he just doesn't like the energy and pressure from the world. Then there's another pro who, you know, was at North Carolina. He's a pro now, but he went to the University of North Carolina. And he literally reached the NBA in his dream sequence and doesn't want to play basketball anymore. And I feel as though it's because people don't value people anymore. It's so transactional. It's all about stats. It's all about these things that really don't define you as a human being. But because we have this status quo, they're not realizing the impact that it's gonna have in the long term. And we have to be more thoughtful about that, because not only is it the impact, it's the outcome. How do you work this hard for something in your life? And I'm coming to you, Dr. Sugar. How does this happen your whole life? You work so hard for something, and then you finally get there and you can't appreciate it. You're doing everything to either self-sabotage, or you're putting yourself in situations that you don't need to be in.
Unfortunately, the social media world has really minimized the things that we work so hard to get to. So these kids have been saying, I want to be a basketball player when I grow up. And then once they see it, that it's right in reach, it's like, okay, that challenge is over, moving on. So it's like, it doesn't give them anything to aspire to because it's so reachable. Like, nothing is out of reach anymore. Everybody is right at your fingertips. Everything is right at your fingertips. It's like, it ain't nothing to be able to go to the league anymore. It's so many people that are able now. Yeah. It's like, it's not like, okay, guys, but what's your real goal?
Yeah.
You can't even say that to kids anymore because now they have access to DM their favorite person. So it's like, there's nothing out of reach.
Absolutely right. And Kendra, I want to know what you think, because the end game, they don't think about that. End game meaning, like, these athletes, you work so hard all the time. We never worked out that much. You know what I'm saying? Had this many trainers, had this many advisors who've never been in the league charge you all this money to make you league ready. Like, this is a travesty. And people not think about the end game, because the end game is that you're burnt out. The end game is that now you're looking for substances and other things to complete you just existing in life. How you feel about that, Kay? Because it's looking like, I mean, we have some real issues coming behind this, not realizing the end game is literally the end.
We definitely have an issue. I would put it more towards the music industry and those kind of things, because when you're an athlete, you really have to work. You have to dribble the ball. You have to know the game. You have to do some exercises. These people that's coming out with these TikTok videos and things that they can easily go viral, that's why you have so many ignorant ass people that can have access to money, and then they acting like they somebody.
She back, y'all. The mic is not getting her to the music. She's back.
But I just really want, where is the talent? You have more talented people that's not out here in the music or on the internet, rather than people without talent, like the Sexy Reds and the things like that, because the things that they say is so outlandish that it goes viral, and now they making money. So now you got dummies with money.
Dummies with money. What you tell them? Dummy with money? It's so many dummies with money that it looked dumb if you got some money, because you ain't even doing what you supposed to be doing with the money. You going around and thinking all this shit define you. But yet, your house look like a one bedroom. You know what I'm talking about? You driving a Phantom with a one bedroom. You driving a Phantom and don't own that one bedroom. You got all this jewelry on that clank, clank, clickety clank when you walk. It don't compute that none of that shit worth what you paid for it. And I ain't talking about the people that just could do it. I'm talking about the people that's trying to compete and compare, and you wasting your time and your money. You know, because, and Kendra, I'm so glad you brought this up, because the music industry, and we're going to have episode 102. I'm not going to say the title, because you crooks will steal it and use it before I get to it next week, because you might tape on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday before we tape again next week. But it is literally brainwashing us into a despair that we have never seen. We not even trying to fix it. It's so profitable to be dumb. And that's why, like, to me, I had to back up. Everyday people have been a part of my journey the entire time. Everyday people is who I am. I am a everyday person. I was in a business that I ended up despising. I was in a business that I thought I loved. No, I didn't love the business. I loved the music. I loved the humans, some of them, that I met. I loved the opportunity to advance my family. Big shout out to Nima the Dreamer, you know, the co-author of What Matters Most. She was in the studio, first guest in the studio, by the way. Nima the Dreamer was here. She's the first guest that has ever been in the studio. And we were just talking about, like, the real. She's like, who would have thought when I DM'd you about something you did that you would hit me back and I would end up writing your book, right? And I'm like, but I saw you. You were already a journalist. You were already in the mix. You hadn't had this look. And I said, I want to give you that look. And then on top of that, y'all, I showed her Loveland. I don't show nobody Loveland. And she is from Africa, was in a civil war, came to the States, and when she walked around this place, she said, this is the African dream. not the American dream. And this is where y'all got to get into humanity and why everyday people are a part of your journey. And if you put them front and center and give them opportunities to shine, give them opportunities to grow, you will see not just the bountifulness of inclusion, but the fruits from that. And I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about what you mean to somebody. You know, we get lost in this world of algorithms and we say all the shit to just be heard, not to actually be saying something. And we out here really doing a disservice when we don't listen. Y'all out here talking, ain't saying shit. And I wanna know y'all opinion because y'all been with me. And from the pandemic till today, from the pandemic, when I sat down at 3 o'clock and I interviewed all them celebrities, and then found out the magic was in the everyday people that came on their post, me interviewing them celebrities, I hired Tiffany. I had 20 different people from the nation, gave them a chance to be co-hosts. Kendra Taylor and Dr. Sheryl Rae Reid. Y'all are now hosts on the Kenny Burns Show. We have 20X our listenership. We have sponsors that pay for the show. You know what I'm saying? We are doing things, and it started with an idea. But more importantly, it started with seeing other people's superpowers. Identifying talent and bringing it into my world. Sugar, how does that make you feel? Because that is the everyday people feeling that makes me go.
Hey, Jim, it's the culture, man. Kenny Burns. You know I'm talking about the dream of motherfucking random. I'm talking fast because I get all these points out in 30 seconds. You have to do me a favor. You have to go to your favorite platform where you listen to the Kenny Burns Show, a.k.a. TKBS, and I need you to download the episodes. We cannot be number one if you don't download. Number two, I need you to write a comment. I don't know why the hell I have a 4.8 on Spotify and I have 5 stars on Apple. Let's make it even. I love you in real life. Stay tuned. We have more TKBS on the way. Peace.
The dream is real.
With the $5 meal deal at McDonald's, 5 hits different. 5 gets you a McDouble or a McChicken and a small fry and a small drink and a 4-piece McNuggets. 5 gets you more at McDonald's. Prices and participation may vary for limited time only.
When you hear a good idea, it's natural to do a double take. That's what you might do when you hear Discover will automatically double the cash back you've earned on your credit card at the end of your first year with cash back match. Wait, what? Yep. Double the cash back is something so good you might do a triple take. It pays to Discover. See terms at discover.com/credit card.
You got 5 on it? With the $5 meal deal at McDonald's, you about to eat. Your choice of a tender, juicy McChicken or a hot, cheesy McDouble sandwich and a crispy 4-piece McNuggets and a small fries and a small drink for just $5.
Money.
Woo. 5 gets you more at McDonald's. Prices and participation may vary for limited time only.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the culture man, Kenny Burns, and you know when I'm working out or doing anything, my attention to detail is unmatched. From my reps to my outfits, everything is sleek and refreshing, just like my smart water. My smart water bottle fits everywhere and is one of my favorite accessories. In a world filled with overthinking, we're providing a refreshing change of pace, a moment of clarity with a simple choice of hydrating with smart water. Life's full of choices. Smart water is a simple one. Visit drinksmartwater.com and learn more.
You know, it's crazy because so many people are opportunistic in the way that they approach things. And I'm not saying that anything is wrong with coming into a situation and looking for the opportunity in it. But if you walk into the situation wondering, well, what can I get if I talk to Kenny Burns?
Right.
No, that's the problem because the authenticity is lost because you are driven by something that is something that's way outlandish. You don't even know. Like I had no clue that while I was working on my dissertation and I clicked go live that he was gonna choose me, number one. Number two, that we were gonna have this contagious energy that just attracted to one another because if y'all have ever met me, y'all know I do not care about the people. If they don't treat other people right, I don't care whether you got money, whether you got status, whether you got shares in Amazon. I don't care. If you are not being kind to the person next to you, if you're being nasty to a waiter, if you're being nasty to the person, like you said, that cleans your room at your hotel, if you're being nasty to your family, that's a problem for me. So I love it that we are in a space that we are all kind to one another and to ourselves. That's the other thing. If you're not kind to yourself, you got some work to do, babe.
Yeah, and Kendra, that's what I love about all of our dynamics. Exactly what she's saying. Like, we literally, we have a time all the time. But it's the way we, you know what I mean? Even like Kendra, you know, it's like me and her had this whole, like, I'm always fucking with her, she always fucking with me. But it's the different way from how me and Sugar get down. You know what I'm saying? Sugar's gonna tell y'all I'm unhinged, but I'm also together. And she, you know what I'm saying? But these are the things that not only entertain y'all, right, in life, because not only you getting, you know, if we're an hour long show, you're getting 50 minutes of information in exchange from professionals. And more importantly, everyday people that live this life to the fullest, right? And then you get to laugh and you get to joke, and you get to have fun. I never forget naming Kendra 14 different names. People got their whole life from that. Just, I mean, you know what I'm saying? And not to be disrespectful to her name, because everybody knows I love her like my family, but y'all get what I'm saying, man. And we got to continue to have that energy and that flavor, you know what I'm saying? Because that's who we are as a people. You know what I'm saying? Kendra, how you feel about that? Because I know, like, for you, and you're an entrepreneur, so you get into this headspace of, like, what is working, what is not? I have to keep it moving. And you still with me.
I am. And I would have thought the first time I met you, you would have been like, I ain't fooling with this girl. Because I was a trip. But I think you like the authentic side of me. That way of saying, like, this girl don't really give a shit, do she?
Yeah.
And we've been laughing ever since.
Yeah.
I didn't know who you were, you didn't know who I was, but we clicked and we meshed, and we still, like, hanging out and having a good time talking shit and, you know, doing our thing. But the camaraderie that we have on this platform that you have created, and even before it was this big platform, when we was just going live, that was an amazing time. Like, that got me through the pandemic, and it also taught me a lot about myself with the conversations that we had with you and with other people in the nation. There's a lot of smart, intelligent people within this community, and even the you may not know this too much, Kenny, but I like to have really deep conversations about whatever. And most of my friends will get on the phone just having a time. But having that community within that live, and now being here and being able to share my story the way that I have lived, and maybe that helps other people. And I have seen that it has. People have made comments about it, and I love it. And I love you for this.
Yeah, I love you back. And the crazy thing is, Jessica offered to pay for her nails today, y'all, because we had a
no
in the algorithm. And she was like, nah, I don't want. I was like, if that was me, she'd have took that nail in a heartbeat, because Jessica offered to her ass. But that's just how you get down. I love you for that. But I want to introduce a new segment. It is called Live from the Comments. Now, ladies and gentlemen, y'all seem to think that we don't hear y'all. We don't be listening. Of course, y'all know Tiffany's ass is listening, because as Hoska Diddy learned this week, you just not going to say whatever and not get your ass handed to you. Now, Hoska Diddy, I love you like cooked food, but you do seem a little Russian bodish this week. But I love you all the same, and I'm always here for you. But in the comments, we've had some very interesting perspective. And I'm going to go to my beautiful co-host, Kendra Taylor Burns, so she can address whatever comment she wants to address.
Now, you brought up our good brother Haas, and my comment is from him.
Oh, it is? Oh,
he stated what up under one of my clips. He said, they not giving that man that office back ever, and get ready for a national state of emergency and some more shit. Now, this is my thing. This is my thing about that. We already in a state of emergency. Don't you see these people out here going freaking crazy? The assassinations attempt that has been on Donald Trump.
The alleged assassination attempt that all seemed like a coup to me, but I'm sorry, go ahead.
Right. They all came from Republican people. People that claim to be Republican. People that have supported his campaigns or his presidency. So I'm trying to figure out what the hell is really going on with that. They're shooting up schools every day. You have bomb threats going off because of certain things that they say out here in the streets, talking about JD and Trump. So we already there. We can't get no worse. The only thing we can do is protect ourselves and move forward.
No, listen, you are dead right. And I want everybody to know this, and this starts the conspiracy theorists in all of us. The eye is in the sky, y'all. And I ain't talking about Jesus. The eye is in the sky, okay? Them cell phones will get you tracked, locked up in some more shit. And you trying to tell me they couldn't see that man on his journey, because I think, Kendra, we were having a sidebar earlier, you told me they was already knowing who it was. It was one of them three named white men that do this type thing. You know what I'm talking about? In the history of the world, they had three names. That's another piece of the conspiracy theory. But the eye in the sky, don't lie. They tracking you. Oh, and by the way, y'all saw my post about Elon Musk. Don't let that go over your head. That man owned like 7,000 or 700, or whatever number of satellites. He got the Neuralink thing gonna put in your head. Y'all better watch out now. Conspiracy Theory Show number 242 coming soon. But Dr. Sugar, I know you have some live from the comments recaps.
Well, I had to go and dig for some because ain't nobody saying nothing under my little clips. So I had to go to Kenny Burns' clip and someone says, "Stop, bro. Guns are inanimate object and won't do anything by itself." Okay, let's start here, friend. Guns are inanimate, but the people that have the guns need regulations. Number one, we need to know who is buying guns. Number one. Number two, people need to have a limit on the guns that they can have. Kendra talked about this in the last episode.
Yes.
Number three, there is absolutely, positively, irrevocably no reason why a person needs to have an automatic weapon in their possession. No person. There is absolutely no reason why you need to be for why. You don't need why? To. No, there's no reason. My daddy hunted my entire life, still will hunt to this day. He have to take his four-wheeler with him, but he's hunting. He ain't got no automatic stuff. He ain't got
Your daddy is on a four-wheeler shooting deer and stuff now?
Not deer. He's more of a rabbit guy and raccoons. But yeah, he got a very nice four-wheeler.
He
must
be a cold shot if he on a four-wheeler with a shotgun.
Yes, my daddy, not the little one. Hello? So yeah, it's just doesn't make sense. So y'all can see the comment is behind Kenny's head. It is a dissertation. And while you were saying a lot of different things, sir, about, you know, the root cause of it is bullying, yada, yada, yada. We understand all of that. But the real issue is we need to find out who has guns and we need some regulations. There need to be some checks and balances on who has ability to get guns. Now, we know the black market is the black market and people gonna get guns. But the thing is, if you have a little bit more of a tracking system, then you can kind of figure out who got what and then have whatever you need to do in order to get those other ones away from the people, because ain't no need.
Yeah, and you be knowing. They be knowing, Sugar. They be knowing who the culprits are in advance. Put them in them cages like you did them people coming through them gates. That wall you said you was gonna put up, Donald Trump. You ran on a whole thing about under your presidency, you was gonna put up a wall. You're a liar. Now I wanna get to my lie from the comments. I was literally confused about my post about how to say Kamala Harris's name. All I did was go listen and watch the DNC. I heard the baby say a great way for people to say her name.
First you say comma like a comma in a sentence.
Then you say la like la 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 la.
Kamala!
And all I did was made a simple post. Child, I have never received this many comments in my life. And I know the majority are Russian bots, because the way they are disrespectful, the way that they are spewing the hate and the rhetoric and the disrespect, it is clearly the bots. But ladies and gentlemen, some of them are real people. And that is the scariest piece to this whole puzzle. Some of them are actually people. I've had NBA players in there. I've had black men, which is unbelievable to me that you can't just show respect to a woman that has earned respect. But the other thing is, y'all, this is what the world is becoming. This is facts. This is how information is being spread. We got to do better, y'all. But before we get out of here, I have to ask Dr. Sugar and then Kendra, how y'all feel about this conversation, because everyday people are being traumatized. Everyday people are being left to the side because of their status. I mean, we covered it all today. You know what I'm saying? But what are we going to do when everyday people are needed and they've been treated the way that they've been treated? Bars, like, what is going to happen with status quo when you can't get the builder? My builder, man, big shout to Armando, man. I can depend on Armando, and he can depend on me. And I show him respect. I don't care if he's remodeling or whatever the case may be. He gets the same treatment I would give a family member. You got a son, I know he played football. I want to know how he doing. Matter of fact, if you are in the neighborhood playing in one of these high schools around me again, let me know so I can pull up. That's just common courtesy, because I do care. You're supposed to care, y'all. Who are we if we don't care about our own?
It's just crazy that we have gotten so far away from community.
Yes.
We used to look out for each other. We used to look out for our neighbors. We used to look out for the people that matter the most to us. We used to look out for strangers.
Yeah.
I have got to find a better way to do better about making sure I'm looking out for other people. Because some people don't know how to receive it, and that's hard for me. Because if I see somebody talking crazy to you in Kroger, I'm pretty much going to say something.
You got to.
Because what if that is the one thing that makes you feel like you matter to somebody else?
It could save their lives.
Yeah. You literally just never know what is going to happen in the next moment. So, like, if my neighbor forgets to pull their trash can back, guess who's pulling it? I got you. That's not a big deal to me. But I think that we've normalized looking out for ourselves so much that we have gotten too far away from making sure everybody is good too.
Hey, Sugar, listen, that is bars, because at the end of the day, you feel better when you do it. You feel better when you help somebody. You know how good I feel all the time because I'm constantly helping someone. It drives me. It fuels me. Kendra, what does it do for you, baby?
When I walk into places to order anything and stuff like that, I always walk in with a big smile, ask the people how they're doing and how's your day. They be so surprised that their whole demeanor changed. Like, they become another person, like, oh, it's great. How about you? And then my service become better. Whenever I go out and have dinner or I'm sitting at the bar, I strike up conversations with anyone. There was this older couple sitting next to me this past weekend. They have been married for about 20 years. We sitting there talking, hugging. I hug some strangers all the time, but we hugging, just conversating. They pay for my entire bill. They left. I did not know until I asked for my bill. She was like, oh, they paid for it. I almost was in tears. Not because it was just the niceness. They didn't brag about it. They didn't say, oh, I'm going to pay for your bill. It was just something, a good gesture that they wanted to do. Being good to people, that come back tenfold.
Yes.
Just be good.
Be a good human. Speaking of good humans, big shout out to Jessica Burns. I got back. I didn't have no sleep on Saturday night. I had 4 hours sleep. I got back and she had breakfast waiting for me. It's like, you know, noon. You know what I'm saying? Perfect. She had my biscuits, my raspberry jelly. You know what I'm talking about? Then she extra touchy. You know what I'm saying? And although I only had 4 hours sleep, I ate my food. And then she came and gave me a hug. And I said, mwah. And I rubbed her ass. You know how you, it's the time. You know, it's the middle of the day. You feel me? And then all of a sudden she started kissing. I said, well, let's go on in the room. And, you know, I did what I had to do, you know what I'm saying, all 4 hours sleep. Now, I could have done a better job because it was 4 hours sleep, so I wasn't all the way. But the food that helped me get through, give her what she needed. And I just, okay, I don't know why I said that, but
I understand.
I just want to tell y'all, you can't do nothing in this life without other people. You can't go through life thinking you're going to be all right by yourself. Everybody needs somebody. All right, y'all, we about to get up out of here before we get to the last segment, but I want my beautiful co-host from Kansas City, because them Chiefs, I don't know, but I know you solid, so just come on and give it to them. Look at them.
Listen, don't start no smoke now. They won fair and square by a point. You know, they pulled it off. Stop being a hater. 1, 2, 3. The dream is real.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for As the World Turns with Kenny Burns. Now, we've been talking about Doo-Doo Don for a long time. And y'all want to know where I got Doo-Doo Don from? Because he always looked like he'd taken a shit. Oh, yeah, that man's face be all over the place. Bars. But I'm going to tell you, you're sleeping on this stupid genius. You want to know why you're sleeping on this stupid genius? Because he told y'all a story about cats and dogs being kidnapped and eaten.
They're eating the dogs. They're eating the cats.
And y'all believe in the shit. Y'all are going down the rabbit hole so far with this alien. That's why this background is purely appropriate and ready for your goofy ass. Because you are following the light. Oh, yeah. I'm talking about a big white orange hair light that is doing you a disservice and continues to lie to you. And the gag is, if you are believing this rhetoric, you too might be part of the problem. Because I am tired. I am tired of seeing the ignorance be ignored. I am tired. I am tired of seeing y'all show up for somebody that will never show up for you. And that's As the World Turns with Kenny Burns. The dream is real. And I love you in real life. Peace.
The dream is real.